Hi, welcome to Freethought Matters. I'm Annie Laurie Gaylor.
And I'm Dan Barker. We are co-presidents of the Freedom From Religion Foundation, a national association of more than 33,000 freethinkers, that's atheists and non-believers, working to keep state and church separate.
Today, we're going to celebrate the real reason for the season, the winter solstice, the shortest, darkest day of the year, which has been celebrated for millennia in the Northern Hemisphere for signaling the rebirth of the sun. Today, we know it as the first day of winter, but almost all the customs associated with Christmas derive from pagan observances of the winter solstice.
And we have a real treat in store for you. A number of freethinking singers and songwriters around the country have recorded for today's show their own seasonal or winter solstice songs.
We'll be hearing from musicians who are all freethinkers. Brent Michael Davids, with a Native American twist on a seasonal favorite. Jazz performers Addison Frei and Tahira Clayton. Topical folk singers Kristen Lems, Shelley Segal, Roy Zimmerman, and jazz vocalist Susan Hofer, and you, Dan.
Also joining us, songwriter Ken Longquist of Madison, Wisconsin. Well, let's start the festivities with the jazz pianist Addison Frei and vocalist Tahira Clayton, who chose a favorite number from the non-religious songwriter Irving Berlin, giving it their own twist.
I'm dreaming of a white solstice, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children, they listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white solstice, with every solstice card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your solstices be white. I used to know, where the treetops they glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow, oh, I'm dreaming of a white solstice, with every solstice card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your solstices be white.
For the award-winning Native American composer and atheist Brent Michael Davids, who has a unique take on the season.
Hi, Brent Michael Davids, wishing you all a happy solstice. Turnabout is fair play, so I decided to culturally appropriate Tchaikovsky's Dance of the Maple Drum Fairies.
Was very cool, Brent. As Brent has pointed out, Christians have been pretty free with appropriating music, such as turning the love song Greensleeves into a Christian hymn known as What Child Is This? So Dan turns the tables in setting new words to the traditional song O Little Town of Bethlehem.
The reason for the season is not the son of a god. The real reason for the season is the sun. O shining star of solstice time, your radiant hours are few. You turn and strike the New Year's chime. We owe our lives to you. These darkest days of winter, we miss your warming rays. But every year this hemisphere returns to brighter days. Since olden days, the human race has feared your warmth would die. The evergreen is ever seen as hope we will survive. Oh, ancient drum, stop beating and superstitions fall. It's time for reason's greetings, for peace, goodwill to all.
Next, we'll hear from irreverent performer Roy Zimmerman.
Hello, FFRF, and thank you for making me part of your solstice celebration. You're right to celebrate the solstice, longest night of the year, shortest day, so it can't get any worse. That's something to celebrate. But of course, it's the holiday season. It's the whole season, and there are so many holidays. Christmas is the cultural behemoth, saying, stand aside, other holidays, for I am Christmas. But there are, you know, are all kinds of holidays all over the world. There's somebody celebrating, you know, this time of year. So for your solstice celebration, I thought I would do a happy song for all the holidays. The mortal world is languishing in deep December snows. The road of hope is frozen over, so's my nose. But even as all nations strive the others to destroy, one holiday brings every nation joy. It's Charisma, Hana, Ramakadana, Kwanzaa. What a merry multicultural time of year. I'm sure no matter where they celebrate over there, the time of year we celebrate over here. No matter what your creed or color, you're sure to have a real good time. A definite yes to answer the question, can we all get along? Let's sing a Christmas song, Hanukkah song. Humanity is drifting in an icy sea of strife. The giant quilt of life is crazy, so's my wife. But even as all things are dying, one event can steer the moribund toward more abundant cheer. It's Charisma, Hana, Ramakadana, Kwanzaa. What a happy heterogeneous holiday. In places near and far, wherever the heck you are, you'll find that they can revel the day away. No matter what your race or religion or lack thereof, you're sure to have a festive night or 8 or 12. A seasonal way for neighbors to say, how could we have been so wrong? Let's sing a Christmas Hanukkah Kwanzaa song. So don a party hat and kill the calf that's fat, and throw a Roman Saturnalia. 'Cause when winter turns to spring and nature does her thing, we'll be wearing frilly frocks, resetting all our clocks for Floralia, Holy Easter, Passover, and Equinox. What a panhumanic extravaganza! What an ethnic culture religio jubilee! We're all joining hands in disparate lands to form a harmonious throng to sing a Christmas Hanukkah Kwanzaa song. So lay aside your crushing load of earthly misery and sing a Christmas Hanukkah Kwanzaa song with me.
And now, our good friend Kristen Lems, a staple on the feminist and modern folk song circuit, has written this dramatic song about why we really celebrate the season.
Hi, this is Kristen Lems, and I'd like to share a song that I wrote for the turning of the seasons, which is my solstice song, written for December 21st, the shortest day of the year, at least in the Northern Hemisphere. Solstice song. This is the time of year for gathering together. We can brave the longest night and all the wintry weather. Longest night we fear you not, for we have kept our hearthstones hot. This is the time of year for gathering together. Winter with its icy breath has thrown its spell upon us. All the birds and geese have left, and ice and snow surround us. But tonight the balance shifts back toward life and all its gifts. This is the time of year for gathering together. Mm-hmm. Force of darkness, force of night, you shall no longer lead us. Rattle the windows, steal the light, but you shall not defeat us. You wrestled us right to the ground, but we will win the coming round. This is the time of year for gathering together. So raise your voice and raise your glass in fellowship and courage. Against the cold, against the odds, our lasting lives will flourish. For we are all brave women and men, and like the sun will rise again. This is the time of year for gathering together. This is the time of year for gathering together.
We'll be back with more of this Winter Solstice musical after this break.
Hi, I'm Ron Reagan, an unabashed atheist, and I'm alarmed by the intrusions of religion into our secular government. That's why I'm asking you to support the Freedom From Religion Foundation, the nation's largest and most effective association of atheists and agnostics, working to keep state and church separate, just like our founding fathers intended. Please support the Freedom From Religion Foundation. Ron Reagan, lifelong atheist, not afraid of burning in hell.
Now, with a new take on holiday trees, is Ken Longquist.
Our city, Madison, Wisconsin, lies on the isthmus between two beautiful lakes, and our Capitol building is situated right in the middle of that isthmus. Every year, when the tree goes up, the controversy is rejoined. Is it a holiday tree, or is it a Christmas tree? And of course, the answer is, it's neither. Oh, isthmus tree, the Capitol Rotunda, find some perplexed and others vexed. Some scratch their heads and wonder, though Christians claim you as their own. Historically, it's widely known your origin was pagan when the Yule tree was plundered. The golden light that glistens from every bough upon you now, shone long before the Christians. Your candle fire the ancients burned to bid the wayward sun return, and songs of light on solstice night stirred hope in hearts that listen. Circuit box and battery can stake no claim to or rename your Yule origination.
In the Southern Hemisphere, December 21 is really the summer solstice. The Australian-born singer-songwriter and atheist Shelley Segal reprises the Tim Minchin song about this time of year from the Australian point of view.
I really like Christmas. It's sentimental, I know, but I just really like it. I'm hardly religious. I'd rather break bread with Dawkins than Desmond Tutu, to be honest. And yes, I have all of the usual objections to consumerism, to the commercialization of an ancient religion, to the westernization of a dead Palestinian press ganged into selling PlayStations and beer. But I still really like it. I'm looking forward to Christmas, but I'm not expecting a visit from Jesus. I'll be seeing my dad, my brother and sister, my gran and my mom. They'll be drinking white wine in the sun. I don't go in for ancient wisdom. I don't believe just because ideas are tenacious, it means that they are worthy. I get freaked out by churches. Some of the hymns that they sing have nice chords, but the lyrics are dodgy. And yes, I have all of the usual objections the miseducation of children who in tax-exempt institutions are taught to externalize blame and to feel ashamed and to judge things as plain right or wrong. But I quite like the songs. I'm not expecting big presents. The old combination of socks, jocks, and chocolates is just fine by me. As I'll be seeing my dad, my brother and sister, my gran and my mom. They'll be drinking white wine in the sun. I'll be seeing my dad, my brother. And you, my baby girl, my jet-lagged infant daughter, you'll be handed around the room like a puppy at a primary school. And you won't understand, but you will learn someday that wherever you are and whatever you face, these are the people who make you feel safe in this world, my sweet blue-eyed girl. And if my baby girl, when you're 21 or 31, and Christmas comes around, and you find yourself 9,000 miles from home, you know. Your brothers and sisters, me and your mom, will be waiting for you in the sun whenever you come. Your brothers and sisters, your aunts and your uncles, grandparents, cousins, me and your mom will be waiting for you in the sun, drinking white wine.
And let's end with the ultimate New Year's Eve song by Scottish freethinker Robert Burns, Auld Lang Syne.
And thank you for watching Freethought Matters.
Because freethought matters. This is actually a recording from our in-person 2017 Winter Solstice event. It will make you nostalgic to see all the people together.
Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should old acquaintance be forgot and Auld Lang Syne? For Auld Lang Syne, my dear, for Auld Lang Syne, we'll take a cup of kindness yet for Auld Lang Syne. And surely you'll buy your pint cup and surely I'll buy mine. We'll take a cup of kindness yet for Auld Lang Syne.
For Auld Lang Syne, my dear, for Auld Lang Syne, we'll take a cup of kindness yet for Auld Lang Syne.
Hi, I'm Steve Pinker. In my book, Enlightenment Now, I show that the world has become a better place as reason has been overcoming superstition and tribalism. But the values of the Enlightenment are under attack. That's why I'm a proud member of the Freedom From Religion Foundation, the nation's largest association of free thinkers working to keep state and church separate. Please join me in supporting the Freedom From Religion Foundation to ensure that our government is driven not by religion, but by reason.